A pair of wire cutters for cutting cable. I'd like to buy these wire cutters.
$1.50, because it's you.
All right, I think I can afford that. Piece of bare cable about 3 feet long. I'll cut into the plastic insulation and pull it back carefully. And now I have a real nice piece of copper wire. I'll just borrow it. All right then, I need the compass. I'll have to sacrifice the telescope. Just right for the directional transmitter. Here are all the things for the direction finder.
Very good. I'll build it up right away. But, first the theory. You take the receiver down to the coast, somewhere near the hotel. You turn on the radio, I'll set everything up, and don't fiddle with it. Then you turn the antenna slowly, and listen for where the Morse code signal is the loudest. Look at the compass and write down the bearings and degrees where the antenna is pointing.
Good.
I'll do the same here with my receiver. Then we'll plot the bearings on this here map. Transmitter's located where the lines cross, understand?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now let me get on with it.
So, let's see. Got it. Back to the junk shop.
And? Do you have a bearing?
Yes, sir. Bearing at 73 degrees.
Very good. My bearing is 90 degrees. Go on, plot the bearings.
Let's see. Your shop is here, and you had a bearing of 90 degrees. I was roughly here. This damn... Of course!
What is it?
A boat! Boris has got a boat. That's why no one here knows him, and why the police didn't find him. The lines cross a few hundred yards from the coast, about 2 miles to the east.
Good work. Now you need a boat. One of those lobster fishermen owes me a favor. You can use his.
And what should I do with it?
Sail out there, of course.
And serve myself up for a fight with Reginald Boris on his ship?
Didn't you hear the message? He plans on coming back into town again tonight, looking for you.
That's what he said? Huh. I must have missed that.
Well, go on, then. You don't get many opportunities to be a hero.
I trust the police least of all. I'd rather get hold of the evidence of Angelina's innocence myself. And this time, it'll all be watertight.
Life jackets, a lifesaver, a few ropes, a buoy, and a gas can. Nothing of use at the moment. A framed sheet of handmade paper. You can hardly read the writing, and there's some kind of wildly painted lines over it. The road to El Dorado is written at the bottom. Isn't that in South America? Let's see. Wow, this is a cool model. Huh. What have we here? A file titled Willow Creek. I don't believe it. Why the hell does Reginald Boris have pictures on his computer of a place where my mother regularly receives money? Something very strange is going on here. Cardboard folder. It looks really new. There's an A on the front. Huh. At the front of the folder is a small piece of transparent foil with lines on it. Strange. I'll take it with me. What else have we got here? Photos of Angelina. Some of them are clearly quite old. She can't be more than 13 or 14 years old in this one. Here she is as a kid. Huh. A note. New York, Boston. Perhaps that's her route? Yes. This proves that Boris has been following her for a while. I'll take the folder. They're photos of me. They're all from yesterday, me walking around town. This is me leaving the store. And here I am going to the hotel. And here I am with Angelina in the diner. Huh. That picture's been taken through the window. That Reginald fella must have been creeping about the whole time. The pictures of a big sailboat on a stormy sea. Maritime romanticism. There are hinges on one side of the frame. A safe. Hopefully it contains a few answers. Here's a windrose that you can turn. I guess the idea is the same as with Fuller's safe. But unfortunately, I don't have a stethoscope with me to listen to the mechanism. Nothing. It might fit. Let's see. The foil fits perfectly. It shows a route around the southern tip of Africa. The route is southwest, south, southeast, east, northeast, and northwest.
the right combination.
Huh. A ring with an eye-catching symbol on it. Looks a bit Celtic. A tree or something. It's not gonna help me, though. A floppy disk.
Labeled with Bideford and today's date. That looks more like a clue. I should have a look at what's on it straight away. If the disk doesn't contain any critical information, then I have to keep searching. Either way, I should get a move on. I don't know how long Boris is gonna stay on land.
Damn, what's wrong now? The battery's dead. And there's no electricity on the boat. Alright, let's see if I can do something about that.